Dying, Christ destroyed our death. Rising, Christ restored our life. Christ will come again in glory. As in baptism, Angela Isabel Hudy put on Christ, so in Christ may she be clothed with glory. Here and now, dear friends, we are God's children. What we shall be has not yet been revealed, but we know that when he appears, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Those who have this hope purify themselves as Christ is pure. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, yet shall they live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. I died, and behold, I am alive forevermore, and I hold the keys of hell and death. Because I live, he said, you shall live also. And so, friends, we have gathered together this afternoon to praise God, to witness to our faith, and to remember and celebrate the life of Angela Isabel Hudy. We come together in grief, acknowledging our human loss. May God grant us grace that in pain we may find comfort, that in sorrow we may find hope, and that in death we find resurrection. My name is Matt Hadley, and I am the senior pastor here at the United Methodist Church of Whitefish Bay. And these are difficult and interesting days, having to come to a sanctuary, to be escorted in, to be separated, to be wearing masks, and to receive these cards. And if you have not received one of these cards for you or your family, we are going to ask that you indeed raise your hand so that we can get these to you. These are our contact tracing cards. Now, if we can get some up here in the front row, these are in case we get report that somebody has tested positive, we know how to contact you. We also know that there was no guest book, no sign-in book, because we didn't want people to be touching the same things. And so this also acts as the guest book, so that the families know who indeed has been here. When service is done, you're invited, as we are being escorted out a different exit, to place your pens and your cards in this basket here before us. I know this is nothing anyone wants to do, but out of abundance of caution, it's what we have to do. And so I invite you at this time to stand as you are willing and able, to look at your bulletin, and we have a call to worship for us this afternoon. We have gathered to honor and remember the life of Angela Isabel Hudy. Let us rejoice in God's presence with us, in death as in life, among those who mourn as with those who now see God face to face. And so our opening hymn, it'll be up on the screen, is the Hymn of Promise. may be seated. Let us pause for a word of prayer. O God, who gave us birth, you are ever more ready to hear than we are to pray. You know our needs before we ask and our ignorance in asking. Give to us now your grace, that as we shrink before the mystery of death, we may see the light of eternity. Speak to us once more your solemn message of life and of death, and help us to live as those who are prepared to die. And when our days here are accomplished, enable us to die as those who go forth to live, so that living or dying, our life may be in you, and that nothing in life or in death will be able to separate us from your great love in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. In your bulletin, there is the 23rd Psalm, and let us join our voices together as one as we read these words. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. The family has selected three brief scripture passages. First two from the pen of the psalmist, and finally from St. John. Psalm chapter 4, verse 8. I will both lie down and sleep in peace. For you alone, O Lord, make me lie down in safety. 34:18. The Lord is near to the brokenhearted and saves the crushed in spirit. And finally, from St. John, chapter 16, verse 33. I have said this to you so that in me you may have peace. In the world you face persecution, but take courage. I have conquered the world. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Well, I'm in my fifth year as the senior pastor here at the United Methodist Church of Whitefish Bay. Over those years, I have had several interactions with Angela, but I think it's safe to say that I did not truly know her. Spent more time with Jamie, actually even more time with JT than I did with Angela. But I'm not going to pretend that I knew her any better than I did, so here is what's going to happen. I am going to be brief with my words, but we need to hear good news. We need to hear the promise that in the shadow of death, as we approach the end of our life here, we know that there is an eternity that we are born into that is love. Endless love, where there is no pain, where there is no disease, where there is no violence, just pure love. And when I'm done speaking, we're going to sing a hymn, and then those who knew her best will have the opportunity to come and to stand, and that's a strong microphone, you can stand back from it, and to share some memories, and then we will receive a video offering. In my 30 years of full-time ministry, I have done hundreds and hundreds of funerals, 53 of them in the year 1997 alone. I've done funerals for people who are more than 105 years old, and I have done funerals for infants. I have done funerals for people who died of natural causes. I have done funerals for those who took their own life. But the younger the individual, the more tragic the passing, the more memorable they are, there are certain deaths that shake me. Things that I can't understand. And I know that for many people, when there are certain circumstances, people maybe even begin to question, is our God really a good God? How can something like this happen? Why are some people born with a disease and illness that is hard? Hard on families, hard on systems. How could God allow that to happen? How could God have allowed Angela to find herself at the wrong place, at the wrong time, with the wrong people? Where are you, God? It's understandable to have anger. But as Jamie said, as we were sitting around a table, there is no more anger. There is just sadness. Now there is suffering. What happened was horrible. But what is next, what Angela is experiencing right now, is clear head, clear mind, pure spirit, endless peace, endless love. I believe that she is now a part of the great cloud of witnesses that the Bible speaks to. These witnesses who surround us. These people, young and old, male and female, who have touched our lives in a number of ways. Jamie said she couldn't save herself, but in death, through donation, three lives are being saved, and we give thanks to God for that. But what I really want you to hear is that there is nothing, nothing, no disease, nothing that can separate us from the love of our God. Paul tried to convey this to the church in Rome when he wrote, "Who will separate us from Christ's love? Will we be separated by trouble or distress or harassment? Or famine, or nakedness, or danger, or sword. But in all these things, we win a sweeping victory through the one who loved us. And I am convinced," he writes, "that nothing can separate us from God's love in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Not in death or life, not angels or rulers, not present things or future things, not powers or height or depth, or any other thing that is created." And so, yes, we have more questions than answers, but we have faith. We believe in that which we cannot see, and we believe that Angela is as safe and as happy as she ever was in her time here on earth. It's my prayer that you have that same assurance. And so we may remain seated as we join together in singing Blessed Assurance. mentioned, I want to give us the opportunity, those who truly walked with Angela, to have an opportunity to share a memory or to share something about the way Angela's life intersected with yours. You're invited to come forward and to stand behind that microphone and to offer any words. And we know that this is awfully intimidating, but the microphone is now open. Yes, sir.
My name is Bill Fleming. My name is Jenny. My daughter's here. Jenny and Lynn met 55 years ago in Oklahoma City. And I think the two of them together were the only reason that they survived Oklahoma City. I was introduced to Bob 47 years ago in this church at a marriage of the two of them. And throughout the years, we've become best friends. Definition of a best friend is not what a person says or does, but it's how you feel in their presence. I was introduced to Jamie when he was born, and the stories, the love, the conversations back and forth between the two about, oh my Lord, what do I do now, and how do I do this and that. And through all those stories, and even today, right now, this moment, I would say that our family and Jamie are best friends. I was also introduced to JT when you were born. Boy, the stories, they were great. Again, the stories didn't vary much. What do? How do we do it? You know, that type of thing. I've seen JT several times over the years, and I would say that again, the definition of a best friend is not what a person says or does, but how you feel. So I would say that we certainly, most definitely, are the best of friends. I was introduced to Angela when they were engaged and got married. And boy, what a great, great stories. The hunting, not the hunting trips, but the fishing trips and the camping and the all the excitement that you heard and the feeling about that beautiful marriage, it was just wonderful. My daughter and my wife came up to a baby shower, and when they were home, I asked about it. I wanted to come, but as my wife so aptly put it, I was not allowed to the baby shower. And they came home and they told me lots of good stories, and through those stories, it was pretty apparent the love and the good person that Angela was at that time and is now. And vicariously through those stories, I feel that we have become best of friends. last time we met Angela was about a year ago, and I think she was working at the corner bakery, and I wanted to see her. We wanted to see her, so we stopped in, and she was behind the counter, and came out, and we hugged, and we all cried. It was just a wonderful moment, emotional moment, but it was a best friend moment. So I would say to everybody here, and this is on the front, that Angela has left us with peace, and for our hearts not to be troubled. Thank you.
Well, good afternoon. I wish it was under better circumstances, obviously, right now. I'm very sorry at this loss, number one. I was shocked when I got the email this Tuesday. I about fell out of my chair, to be honest. I'm an apartment manager here in Whitefish Bay, doing some other jobs on the side right now. I can remember few years ago, I think 3-4 years ago, when I met JT and James and Angela. And Wednesday Night Live is I'm a frequent visitor to over the years that I was here. And we hit it off so well immediately. I could tell the love that was there in that family. I could tell that they had been raised extremely well. Even Angela's struggles aside, she was a sweet woman. That picture of her is her. That's who she was. That's what I will always remember from her. And she's going to be missed dearly. I'm going to be honest. I lost my mother the end of February this year. Had a memorial service just a little over a month ago in this same place. 2020, besides everything that's happening to us nationally, has been a tougher year than ever for me. But now I can relate to Jim and JT up close. And it's hard. I'm getting through things, but God's in control. I always said he's in charge of this place. We're not. And I'll just close. I thank you. Hope we can all stay in touch here. But I think that one of my favorite authors, Charlotte Bronte, a big student of the Brontes, some of you may know who they are. Charlotte Bronte once said, she died at a very young age too. She said, I've written over 200,000 words about humanity and I still don't understand it. That's a reminder that God and Jesus Christ are in control of this world and this place, which is why we need to stay as close to them as ever. And especially now to Jim and JT, just lean on God as best you can, because he's the only one that can bring the peace, the real peace. I know he's done it to me over the last 7 or 8 months. With that, Godspeed. Thank you. Thank you for everyone coming here. And Angela will be in my memory forever. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. I'm Angela's youngest sister, youngest sibling. I have no idea what I'm going to say. Just letting you know. She had a lot going on, you guys. She had a lot going on. She always did. And when Alicia left, things got really hard, I think, for everyone. And it took a lot out on her. But the thing that always amazes me, and I was trying to come up with words earlier today, and there was no words. I really just was like, got nothing. But the thing that I wanted everybody to remember the most about her was that she always had a way of making friends everywhere she went. And I swear, it bothered me so much. It bothered me so much. I mean, even when I was trying at one point to get her help, she's making friends at Rogers. Like, she's making friends in the doorway, and I'm just driven nuts by it, but I'm like constantly remembered by that's who she was. Everywhere she went, every single person she met, and no matter how hard of a struggle she was going through, I could always call her. And it scared me to call her sometimes. Because when somebody's such an emotional wreck, you're afraid to emotionally go to that person for something. But she was my big sister. And in those moments, that's who she was again. And being afraid didn't mean anything. She was there for me no matter what. And she touched a lot of people. And I'm going to try to forget all of that bad stuff. And I'm going to try to remember that I live in the neighborhood that we grew up in. across from the pool that we went swimming in. That is now demolitioned and being renovated, but there's a lot of memories right where I'm living, and I'm gonna live in those memories, and I encourage everybody to live in all of the good ones, because that's what she would want. So I loved her a lot. And everybody that knew us as kids knew that she was the person I idolized. And being a younger sister, that's really, it's weird when that table seems to be turning as you get older. And when you can see somebody in a rut, and she knows she was in a rut, and to look at me with any bit of looking up to your younger sister was really strange. And the last day I saw her, that's the thing I said to her, was that I'll always look up to you, because that's what you do. So thank you, everybody, for all of the love. I can't tell you how much love has been given to myself, to Angela, by people that don't even know her. It's beyond me, the amount of love that I have felt in the last 3 weeks. So thank you, everyone. I love you.
Live into the memories. Is anyone else who would like to share a thought? Well, seeing none, I know it can be intimidating, but I hope that you will continue to tell stories, good stories, stories from the best times of her life. And so why don't we receive this video offering that was put together for us this day.
As long as you stay, stand by.
Let us pray. God of us all, your love never ends. When all else fails, you still are God. We pray to you for one another in our need, and for all, anywhere, who mourn with us this day. To those who doubt, give light. To those who are weak, strength. To all who have sinned, mercy. To all who sorrow, your peace. Keep true in us the love with which we hold one another. In all our ways, we trust you. And to you, with your church on earth and in heaven, we offer honor and glory. And so, O God, all that you have given us is yours. As first you gave Angela to us, now, Lord, we give her back to you. Receive Angela into the arms of your mercy and raise her up with all your people. Receive us also and raise us into a new life. Help us so to love and serve you in this world that we may enter into your joy in the world to come. And so it is into your hands, O merciful Savior, that we commend your servant. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive Angela into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints of light. All this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, our Savior, who taught us to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. I invite you to stand as you are willing and able, and we have one final hymn, Love Divine, All Loves Excelling.
Fix in us thy love, Lord.
just as a reminder that we're going to be inviting you to exit through this entrance and place your contact cards and any pens that you borrowed in our tray. Friends, let's keep the memories alive. Let's celebrate love. And so the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, being among you and remain with you all always. Amen.